Hello everyone, welcome back to Geek Disorder's web series over HTML5, CSS3, JavaScript, and jQuery. This is Lavik, I'll be going over this series with you. Today we're going to go over the core attributes. Two of them, the class and the ID, we've already went over, but these are two important ones, so I figured this is a good place to kind of reiterate on those. We'll also be discussing two new ones, that is the title and the language attribute. Okay, let's go ahead and get started. Well, I'm going to go ahead and set up the whole document for this one because there are a couple places I'd like to talk about. All right, first thing we need to do is we need to save this as a web page, and I've already got one, if I could find it here, on my desktop. Our core attributes, and I'm just going to call this core.html. And here we go. Alright, first thing you need, of course, is your doc type. Alright, HTML. And then, of course, we want to start our HTML here. And I'm going to go ahead and close it. We need our head element. Close the head element. Then we need our body element. Close it. Alright, we got our basic web page set up. There are a few things we need, and this is a new one. We're going to go over the language attribute first because we're actually going to use it first. When you open up your HTML tag, this is mainly for screen readers and such, and it also helps out search engines. It's called the language element, and it looks like this right here. It's language equals, and inside the content of your attribute here, you put what language you're using. We're using English, so English is EM. And there we go. When a search engine goes over your web page, it's going to hit this language element, and it's going to notice that it's set to English. So if someone is searching and they restrict their searches based off the language used, it's going to include yours with English. It's going to know what language to put your web page in. That could help you if they're restricting based on language. Something else is screen readers. They need to know what language your web page is in so they can know what language to use to, you know, read the document. And it also helps with them knowing how to pronunciate certain words. So you always want to set that. It's an accessibility thing. And it also helps with search engines and stuff like that. Alright, and with these core attributes, there is one thing to know is they can be coded into most HTML elements. So if somewhere down the line you have, say, a paragraph, and that paragraph is in French, you can change the language for that paragraph, okay, to French, and so on. Alright, there's that, and of course I'm going to fill in the header here, and remember the meta tag you always need is your character set, and we're going to set that equal to UTF-8, whoops, 8, there we go. Alright, okay, alright, the next thing we need is a title, so I'm going to go ahead and put a title here, and I'm just going to call this core attributes, whoops. All right. Now we can move down into our body of our web page here. All right. We learned about the language tag, and remember, I used it here in the HTML tag. Remember, you can use the, and that's the, where you want to use it. But you, if needed, you can also use it in just about any other element to specify a different language. All right. The next attribute we're going to look at is the title attribute. All right. The title attribute. Well, we learned about the title element, which is right here, and this is a title attribute. The title element titles your web page. It displays, you know, the title up here in the this browser bar. Well, the title attribute is kind of the same thing. It titles an element. And so I'm going to use it on a paragraph here. Go ahead and just, and we'll put this is a paragraph. Alright, and I'm going to add a title attribute to this, and the way I do that is title equals, and then I add in my content for this title tag, and I'll put I'm just gonna put paragraph, so we don't. All right, there we go. I'm gonna save this, and I'm gonna run it in Firefox. And inside the paragraph element, I put this is a paragraph. That's the content of that element. Inside the title attribute on that paragraph element, I put paragraph. So we can't see the attribute. The way we look at the attribute, the way the attribute affects this paragraph element, is if I hover over the content, there you go. I have a pop-up that says paragraph. That's from the title. That's where it grabs that information from, and it gives me a pop-up. That's the way the title attribute works most of the time. Okay. So that is the title attribute. Remember, when you can place it in it almost any element. If you look at images, sometimes you want to give images a title. Sometimes you want to give input a title, and so on. So the next two are the class and the ID, and those two we've already went over before, but these two are very important, so I'll give them a refresher. The class and ID names. So if I put in a paragraph here, alright, I'm just going to create two paragraphs here. Alright, and this top one is going to be for my ID. I'm going to set that equal to say main paragraph. Alright, the second one is going to be my class, and I'll just set equal to, let's say, blue BG. Alright, let's look at these. Well, the IDs and class names. That is this right here, this main paragraph and this blue BG. What you name those, there are some rules to that. They are case sensitive. So you couldn't, somewhere in your CSS put blue BG with a lowercase b. Not going to be the same thing. So it's not going to connect these two together. They have to be the same case. So everything that's lowercase in this title has to be lowercase when you use it somewhere else. Everything that's uppercase has to be uppercase. Alright, they should start with a letter. They can include letters, numbers, underscores, hyphens, colons, and periods. So that's all the stuff you can use when creating the name. But remember, they should start with a letter. Okay, so what does the ID and what does the class do? Well, we'll be using these a lot more when we get into the CSS side of things. You'll really learn how they interact. CSS interacts with HTML and how the class and ID work when we get to that section. But a brief overview of what the class and the ID does is an ID is unique. You can use an ID once. So this main paragraph ID right here, I can only use once through my web page. Most of the time, people like to create a div and call it, content or web page or main page or, body, something along that lines, and that's the name they give their ID for that div. And what they're saying is this right here, this div, I'm putting all my content inside this div. And of course, you're not going to have another main page or another body or anything like that, so that's a good use for an ID. It is unique. It can only be used once. You can have multiple IDs throughout your web page, but they cannot have the same name. So I can only use main paragraph one time. Class, on the other hand, is not unique. It can be used repeatedly in your web page. So anything I want to have a blue background, if that's what this class does, if it ties in with my CSS, and anything I give this class the name blue background, CSS will give that element a blue background. So I could put this throughout my web page and give all my paragraphs except for one the class blue background, and every paragraph that has the class blue background will get a blue background. The ones that don't will not. Okay, so that's kind of how the class and ID works. And so I believe next we're going to actually get in to like the div and span elements and so on. So we're actually going to learn some of the building blocks of our web pages and how to structure web pages. So this has been Lavik with Geek Disorder. If you like our content, please subscribe. Please share us. Leave a comment. We'll try to get back with you. All right, and we'll see you next time. Thank you.